live from Brisbane, 7 News with Kendall Gilding.
Good afternoon. Our top stories this Friday. Ocean rescue. The difficult mission to free two whales tangled in shark nets off the Gold Coast. Cyber attack. The Prime Minister reveals hackers have targeted Australia as experts point the finger at China. Community justice. Logan residents arm themselves and take action to stop car thieves in their neighbourhood. And cut price flights. The airlines launch a massive sale to generate an income for their struggling industry. First at four, two whales tangled in shark nets have sparked a major rescue operation off the Gold Coast. Crews battled pouring rain and choppy surf as they tried to cut the mammals free. Carly Madsen was there.
This certainly was an incredibly difficult mission. Mother Nature almost seemed to be working against the rescue crews as they tried to free a baby whale and a bigger one, likely its mother, tangled in the shark nets off Main Beach.
The female was around 10 metres long. Calf was probably a couple of metres in length, so it's a relative new one.
The pair were noticed struggling about 300 metres offshore around midday. SeaWorld and Fisheries were quick to respond, but both whales were already badly tangled in the ropes of the net. After half an hour, the mesh was wrapped around them, and as each rope was cut, the whales would push further along the net, catching themselves again and again.
They had a lot of mesh. They had mesh over the head on both and a little bit on the pec fin.
Finally, after half an hour, the pair was cut free. But they aren't safe yet. As they swam into deeper water, ropes could be seen trailing behind them.
We were able to put a grapple on there and a buoy, and a little bit of manoeuvring managed to remove that mesh from its head.
This is now the second rescue this migration season, and it's only just begun, reigniting the age-old debate over whether the shark nets should be removed.
Australia is under attack by a sophisticated cyber force. Prime Minister Scott Morrison has warned all levels of government and private organisations are being targeted. Jennifer Beshwati has the details from Canberra.
Well, it's been described as a sophisticated, malicious cyber attack on our critical services. The Prime Minister today says it's a very serious matter and he's taking swift action.
Australia has some of the best agencies in the world on these issues. We have been working together to thwart this activity.
So far, it's understood the cyber attack is targeting all levels of government, industry and political organisations, education, health, essential service providers and operators of critical infrastructure.
Regrettably, this activity is not new, but frequency has been increasing.
Personal and financial details have not been compromised.
The investigations conducted so far have not revealed any large-scale personal data breaches.
While the Prime Minister won't name the country behind the attack,
Australia doesn't engage lightly in public attributions.
The head of Australia's Strategic Policy Institute does.
You can be absolutely certain that it's Beijing.
Mr Jennings says China's motive could be to gain intelligence from our state and federal leaders, but also
straight out bullying. It's a warning to Australia to say, look at what we can do. You guys had better behave yourself.
Now, while the attack is not targeting ordinary Australians, experts are warning everyone to remain vigilant. Keep your software up to date and change your passwords regularly.
Logan residents, fed up with criminals targeting their community, have taken the law into their own hands. Armed with baseball bats, the vigilantes caught a trio of teens breaking into cars. Mac Lyon reports.
The people of Killara Estate here in Logan Reserve have a message for would-be thieves. Commit crime here and we will catch you.
We just want to help the community out any way we can.
Just before midnight, a resident's home security camera captured a group of teenagers trying to break into cars. They sent a message to the community's emergency Facebook group and Henry answered the call.
Playing a bit of Fortnite with my little cousins. About midnight, I saw the page go off.
Armed with a baseball bat, Henry jumped in his car and went hunting. It wasn't long before he caught up with the trio as they were jumping over a back fence off Killara Boulevard.
When I walked up with them with the bat, they just went straight to the ground. Just a warning, guys, I didn't use it.
With the help of half a dozen fellow residents, he says the boys, aged 13 and 14, were pinned to the ground and given a stern talking to.
And we told them, look, people work hard for the you know, the things they have around here, their houses, their cars, etc.
When police arrived and searched them, they found two wallets and a watch believed to be stolen. Two of the boys were taken to hospital for treatment. The other has been released with no charges laid yet.
It was disappointing to see them up there, taking things that don't belong to them.
Police investigations are continuing.
Queensland has reached a milestone in the fight against coronavirus, reaching 250,000 tests conducted in the state. Despite the high number of tests, positive cases are now rare. Joel Dry explains.
Well, here in Queensland, the news on the COVID-19 front continues to be good. Once again, there were no new cases overnight, and that's despite well over 3,000 tests being conducted. There are now just 4 active cases in the state and no one in intensive care. We have all but smashed community transmission, and that has given more states the confidence to open their borders to Queensland, including South Australia. Their Premier today announcing from midnight tonight, we can travel to that southern state. But here, the Health Minister maintains there's still some work to be done before our own borders reopen, particularly in Victoria, where another 12 cases were recorded, including some that were community transmission.
I think it underlines how irresponsible some of the calls to open the borders earlier have been. We want to be able to see Victoria get on top of this local community transmission.
So no movement on borders, but in other areas there's progress, including our stadiums, which are preparing to welcome fans back this weekend.
It's great to be back and see all the players.
Crowds of up to 2,000 people are expected at this weekend's fixtures. It is being seen as a big test as the government once again prepares to review restrictions at the end of the month.
To a developing story now, and a major manhunt is underway in Auckland after a routine traffic stop turned deadly. A police officer has been killed and another is seriously injured after both were shot. A member of the public was also injured after they were run down by the driver. Jackie Trad will know within a fortnight the outcome of a corruption investigation into allegations she interfered in the selection of a school principal. To Patrick Lyon now. Pat, there's questions today about how long Ms. Trad was under investigation without knowing it.
Yes, Kendall, we learned today that Ms. Trad was actually under investigation since December, and she sat in Cabinet for 6 months making decisions without actually knowing this. This came out of a Triple C hearing. Of course, Ms. Trad resigned in May when she was actually told for the first time by the Triple C, and that is Premier's protocol when ministers are put under investigation. Ms. Trad explains that she tried to ask in February what was happening but was rebuffed. Mr. McSporran, the Triple C chair, says she may have suspected she was being investigated, but in the end he takes the blame.
The Triple C very often does investigations without notifying people.
Look, it is extraordinary that Jackie Trad sat around Anastasia Palaszczuk's cabinet table for months while she was under active investigation.
The investigation's finished and we're going to issue a public report, which should be in the next couple of weeks.
Also at the Triple C hearing today, we heard the Chair's verdict on the Trad laws, so-called Trad laws, and they passed Parliament this week, including a controversial element that they'd only catch intentional failed declarations by ministers. There's been lots of claims that the government's laws do comply with the Triple C recommendations. Today, Mr. McSporran said they don't.
All right, Patrick Lyon, thank you. There's an added incentive to book an Australian holiday with cheap airfares on sale from today. The cut price tickets won't just save holiday makers some money, they could also protect tourism and travel industry jobs. The cheapest fares start at $19. Steve Titmus has more.
Good afternoon. Jetstar is offering 10,000 cheap seats and Qantas is also on board, tripling frequent flyer points. 200,000 Jetstar flights, 10,000 as low as $19. Among the eligible destinations, Sydney to the Gold and Sunshine Coast and Melbourne to Proserpine, close to the Great Barrier Reef and Airlie Beach.
To stimulate the economy, the small businesses, the tourism businesses, the local communities that have been doing it tough through this.
Flights to Queensland time to start July 21 after the border is open but flexible.
And because plans do change, all of the fares that will be sold have a flexibility option associated with them that customers can make a fee-free date change any time up to the time of travel.
The tourism and travel sector is applauding the cheap flights as a stimulus to get the market back up and running. Flight Centre, headquartered in Brisbane, one of the hardest hit by the pandemic.
We've stood down globally about 12 or 13,000 people.
Meanwhile, with thousands of tourism jobs already lost, there are new fears that more jobs could go in the coming months.
Well, let's get a check on today's weather now. Let's catch up with Paul Burt.
Thanks for that, Kendall. Hello, everybody. Well, it certainly has been a bit of a sunny, rainy kind of day today. Not as much as yesterday. A little sprinkle of a sun shower here on the Gold Coast at the moment and some beautiful rainbows about the southeast as well. Let's take a look at the beach conditions for tomorrow because I think we're going to see a little bit more shower activity tomorrow, particularly in the afternoon. But at this stage here, that swell still coming in from the east. So it's welcoming for the board riders, particularly when the point's at morning high tide. It's not a big tide. So it might be a little bit fat and full early up. But those winds will ease back, so try the open beaches early and then the points. And, of course, just stay away from the crowds. But water temps around 21 degrees. Speaking of 21 degrees, today's temperatures hovered around 20 to 21 across most coastal regions and in towards Logan as well. 19 down here on the Gold Coast. 22 degrees out in the west around Ipswich. And a few showers there, Kendall, but lovely to see. I'll be back with more weather shortly.
It's good to see you catching some sun there this afternoon. Thanks, Bertie. See you soon. Still to come on Seven's Afternoon News, an education shake-up. The cost of some university degrees slashed, while others will double. War of words, Trump takes aim at the author of a tell-all book. And Queensland tourism operators stay busy planting coral on the Great Barrier Reef. On 7 News, Australia's massive cyber attack, what you must do. The race to save humpbacks off Main Beach. Logan vigilantes take on serial thieves. COVID-19 bargains, ultra-cheap airfares.
As low as $19.
Fees slashed on uni degrees and the caterer selling $2 meals. 7 News at 6.
Normally, I'm the one on stage telling the jokes. But this is one time I don't want anybody to laugh.
Who will dare to bear?
Can you guess who said yes to undress?
Who is it? The all-new Monty Guys and Gals, this July on 7.
Join AHM Hospital and Extras Direct and you'll get 6 weeks free. Plus, we'll waive any 2 and 6 month waits on Extras.
Yay!
Whether you're a single, a couple, or a family. It's that simple. That doesn't look very simple. Offer ends June 30. Find out more and join AHM Direct today. AHM, the simple bit.
You know you'll make a great mum one day.
Wise men say.
You know, I had the weirdest cravings when I was pregnant with you. Pickles and ice cream.
Oh, if I...
What are you looking at, hon?
Oh, just a little bit of T&W.
Huh? Hey, I got a package for Anna.
Wow, you're here already.
Temple and Webster. Save today on our massive end of financial year sale.
9, 10.
A chesty cough can ruin more than just your day. Treat it with Duratus Chesty Fort Liquid. Its double-action formula breaks down mucus and clears chest congestion. Not surprisingly, you can feel better sooner. Get Duratus Chesty Fort Liquid for a great price at Chemist Warehouse.
Keithy Turnip's up next. He fires the ball. Sucked in, Soap Dodger.
Catch this. For NRL this Thursday and Friday, lead by 4 points or more at halftime and we'll pay you out straight away. Four up, you win with Sportsbet.
Thanks to Light and Easy, Australians of all ages can enjoy their choice of delicious, nutritious meals in the comfort and safety of their own home. especially those at a greater health risk during these times. If you or someone close to you could benefit by having Light and Easy meals delivered safely with our contactless delivery service, visit lightandeasy.com.au or call us on 13 15 12.
With Belong, you get 10 gigs of mobile data for $25 a month. That's 10 gigs of family time, plus unlimited international calls and texts to selected countries for $5 extra. Together, we're different. Belong.
Toy Mania is back at Big W. Brighten up their day with the Barbie Colour Reveal dolls, just $19, and the Barbie Dreamhouse, $199, all backed by our Toy Mania price match guarantee. Big W, every day is a big day.
Head to Macca's if a little treat is what you need and get six of our new delicious donut balls for just $3 or 18 chicken McNuggets and two large fries for $9.95.
Fees for arts, law and commerce degrees will skyrocket as part of a new plan to encourage school leavers to study fields that make them job ready. The changes will kick in next year, affecting a sector already hit hard by COVID-19. Katrina Blowers reports.
Well, this is essentially a carrot and stick approach, enticing students towards what are considered to be job-ready degrees and discouraging students away from others. Under the plan, the cost of an arts degree will more than double from next year, while fees for mathematics, agriculture, IT and nursing will be slashed. The massive reform is aimed at encouraging students to study in jobs with greater employment prospects and to choose more practical options during the post-pandemic economic downturn.
We're incentivising students to study in the areas where we know there will be jobs.
But there is a way students who study arts or humanities degrees can cut the cost of their education, and that's by choosing elective subjects in priority areas like maths, languages or IT. Subjects in nursing, psychology, English languages, teaching and even architecture will be cheaper. The government says its priorities have been defined by pre-pandemic modelling, showing 62% of employment growth in the next 5 years will be in healthcare, science and technology, education and construction. Now, these fee increases will not affect current students, and anyone enrolled in any of these subjects will have their fees frozen.
Victim impact statements and a petition with 17,000 signatures have been handed to the Queensland Parole Board president in a bid to keep the Childers backpacker killer Robert Long in jail. He was found guilty of setting the hostel alight and convicted of murdering two of the 15 backpackers who died, but he'll soon be eligible for parole.
We fully understand the Parole Board has criteria to work within, but we've been assured that victim impact statements are one of the criteria that they will look at.
Tuesday marks the fatal fire's 20th anniversary. Donald Trump has slammed former National Security Advisor John Bolton over his book, which claims the US president is unfit for office. The White House has taken legal action to block the book from being published. Paul Kadak reports.
Good afternoon. A war of words has erupted over the words of John Bolton in this book, where he's served up a scathing assessment of his former boss, writing that President Donald Trump is easily flattered by authoritarian leaders, that Russian President Vladimir Putin thinks he can, quote, play him like a fiddle, and that during negotiations with China, Trump asked President Xi to buy American farm products to boost his election prospects, quote, pleading with Xi to ensure he'd win, and that appearances with North Korea's Kim Jong-un were more about the photo op than the best interests of the US.
I don't think he's fit for office. I don't think he has the competence to carry out the job. There really isn't any guiding principle that I was able to discern other than what's good for Donald Trump's re-election.
Donald Trump hitting back, calling Bolton a liar and disgruntled, boring fool who everyone in the White House hated.
He couldn't get Senate confirmed, so I gave him a non-Senate confirmed position where I could just put him there, see how he worked. And I wasn't very enamored.
Bolton's also been criticized for refusing to testify without a subpoena during Trump's impeachment. He blames Democrats for not making their investigation more than about Ukraine. Now, the Justice Department is taking legal action to delay publication of the book over classified information, but for now, it is set for release next week.
While waiting for visitors to return, tourist guides in the Whitsundays have stayed busy helping protect the Great Barrier Reef. Up to 60 tourism workers and local conservationists have planted 1,000 baby coral.
This goes to the heart of rebuilding this critical ecosystem that's faced some, you know, significant dark days recently with some cyclones and then, of course, climate change.
The Great Barrier Reef Foundation wants to establish a network of protected areas similar to this one. Just ahead, remembering a famous World War II songstress, the incredible life of Dame Vera Lynn. Show of force, which superpower is flexing their missile muscle? And the Gold Coast mayor dives right in to show off a new tourist attraction.
Paid to drop your kids to school. The cashback for Queensland parents, up to $100 a week.
A lot of parents don't know about it.
The school zones where you can claim.
It helps us heaps with the petrol.
How it's saving parents thousands across the year. Only on 7 News at 6 o'clock. The cash cow's rocketing for a world brekkie record. 24 million given away.
Oh, you're kidding.
Only on...
The Good Guys TV sale is on now. Get up to 15% off a huge range of TVs. Like $525 off this Samsung TV, $330 off this Hisense TV, plus bonus delivery and installation when you buy an interest-free. Only at The Good Guys.
Hey, Tina, can you please slice the lettuce, tomato and onions, toast the buns, grab the sauce and mayo and... Oh, and bring the meat.
Take a break from cooking and get Hungry Jack's Flame Grill Whoppers delivered now on Uber Eats or Menu Lock. Hungry Jack's delivery. The burgers are better.
Is mild osteoarthritis pain getting in the way of enjoying everyday life? Try Panadol Osteo from your local Terry White Chemmart. With its unique bilayer technology, it provides both fast and long-lasting osteoarthritis pain relief for up to 8 hours. And to keep you going all day, consider using Voltaren Osteo Gel 12 hourly. With just 2 applications a day, it gives you joint pain relief for the whole day and all night. Panadol Osteo and Voltaren Osteo Gel 12 hourly are on sale now at Terry White Chemmart. Now that's real chemistry.
Buy any new or pre-owned car at the Motorama 3-day sale and you'll spin to win up to $2,000 cash. Motorama Spin to Win, new and pre-owned, must end Saturday. Maruka, Browns Plains and Springwood.
Autobarn have massive savings this Friday and Saturday. We're taking 25% off everything store-wide. Want more? Grab 30% off batteries, 30% off dash cams and 30% off engine oils. Huge savings store-wide this Friday and Saturday. In-store and online at Autobarn.
If you were injured on the road, get advice before it's too late. Contact Shine Lawyers to access compensation through your superannuation.
Yeah, I've heard Shine can help.
Shine Lawyers, let's right wrong.
Muscle and osteo pain can really tie you down. That pain is caused by inflammation. Nurofen helps reduce inflammation and relieve osteo and muscle pain for up to 8 hours. Break free with Nurofen.
Now I need to find an aged care worker, someone to pick up groceries, and a nurse to assist me with medication.
Mabel has over 10,000 independent care and support workers ready to help you. Find your people at mabel.com.au.
You're relying on our network more, so we're accelerating the rollout of Telstra 5G, giving more people and businesses access to fast download speeds in more places than ever.
Macca's new cheesy burgers are your favourites, only cheesier. A golden mozzarella patty with 100% Aussie beef or chicken. And mozzarella sticks are back. Macca's new cheesy range, only for a limited time.
Protests have flared across India as tensions rise over the deaths of 20 soldiers in brutal hand-to-hand fighting with Chinese troops. The clashes happened in a disputed mountainous border region this week. Effigies of the Chinese president were burned by protesters as they called for a boycott on Chinese products. Dame Vera Lynn is being remembered today as the voice of the Second World War generation after her death at the age of 103. Her signature tune, We'll Meet Again, struck a chord with Allied troops and became an anthem of hope in desperate times.
We'll meet again. Don't know when. Don't know when.
She was the Force's sweetheart, whose songs of home helped lift spirits during the darkest days of World War II.
Underneath the lantern by the barricade.
Not only did she help keep the home fires burning, she also visited the troops on the front line, singing to the forces in North Africa, the Middle East, and even the jungles of Burma as the Allies fought a brutal war against the Japanese. She was awarded an OBE in 1968 and 7 years later became Dame Vera Lynn. When she turned 100, the whole of Britain helped her celebrate. Her image fittingly beamed onto the white cliffs of Dover. Her last public concert was at Buckingham Palace to mark the 50th anniversary of VE Day.
And a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square.
During this current war against coronavirus, her songs have again played to the heartstrings. The Queen echoing her words during a televised address in April.
We will be with our families again. We will meet again.
Dame Vera passed away surrounded by family. Her voice and her legacy will live on. In London, Hugh Whitfeld, 7 News.
Iran says it has successfully tested a new naval cruise missile, and these pictures appear to back that up. Short and long-range missiles can be seen fired from land and sea, hitting targets with precision near the Gulf of Oman. The test firing comes as the US seeks an extension of a UN-imposed arms embargo against Iran. Security Vision has exposed a gang of arsonists moments before a Houston bar went up in flames. Four men armed with 20-litre containers of flammable liquid are seen dousing the property before a trailer was ignited and pushed into the bar, causing over $1 million in damage. Police are hunting for the suspects, believed to be suffering from burns. And deadly floods in Turkey have very nearly claimed another victim. This dramatic vision shows a woman being swept away down a flooded street in a torrent of rising water. Luckily, a local shopkeeper came to the rescue. The woman was taken to hospital and is said to be in a good condition. Gold Coast Mayor Tom Tate has gone hands-on at the launch of a new tourism business. The operation takes adventurers on a tour of the Broadwater on battery-powered hydrofoil surfboards. But before Tom Tate could get hit to his feet, he slipped forward headfirst into the canal.
Got air up there and got a bit of water in my lungs and we stopped.
For anyone who is game enough, the Gold Coast hydrofoil tours are now operating through online bookings. And we will farewell our Gold Coast viewers now. Thanks so much for your company. You're off to the chase. And Amanda Abate has your local 7 Gold Coast news at 5:30. For the rest of Queensland, our lowest paid workers are getting a pay rise. The minimum wage is about to go up, but the pandemic means some will have to wait even longer to get it. A royal welcome for the French president in London. And a walk on the wild side, how this curious pig wound up far from home.
On 7 News, Australia's massive cyber attack, what you must do. The race to save humpbacks off Main Beach. Logan vigilantes take on serial thieves. COVID-19 bargains, ultra-cheap airfares.
As low as $19.
Fees slashed on uni degrees and the caterer selling $2 meals. 7 News at 6.
9 marriages, 20 Aussie kids. The most beautiful love stories have been born from the only show that proves
the power of love. Real love is back.
New Farmer Wants a Wife, this July on 7.
On a brekkie run?
How did you know?
Get your Woolies worth with great specials like Uncle Toby's Quick Oat Sachets 12 packs, now $3 each. That's half price.
That's why I pick Woolies.
Unpolished beauty. It defines our country. And at Stratco, it's what we do. Custom crafting, roofing and cladding solutions for remarkable Australian homes. Colourbond steel, stunning matte finish. Brought to life by Stratco How To.
Get on the road again with Apollo and Kratzmann's biggest ever end of financial year RV Super Sale. Over 250 new and used RVs in stock. Save up to 10 grand on brand new caravans, new campers from $16,990, new motorhomes from $103,990, new family vans from $41,990. Plus, go the extra distance with a bonus $500 fuel voucher on any used RV purchase. Apollo and Kratzmann's biggest ever RV Super Sale won't last long. Go online, give us a call or come on in, but be quick. Sale only while stocks last.
Shut up and take my money.
Nothing like a party in the summertime. Nothing like seeing you, baby, looking so fine. Ooh, nothing like a party.
Step one has been designed to solve every underwear problem a man could ever have. These lycra panels stop them from chafing or riding up. And this 3D pouch is lined with elastic, so you'll never readjust again. Love them or they're free. Buy them online at step1.life.
Huge Harvey Norman home entertainment deals on now with 60 months interest free. Save over $800 on this amazing Samsung 85-inch QLED TV, or save over $500 on this Samsung 82-inch Crystal 4K Smart TV, now under $3,000. Get this Samsung 5.1 channel soundbar, now only $525. Or this Hisense 65-inch 4K Smart TV, now only $1,259. Plus many more deals at Harvey Norman now.
Live from Brisbane, 7 News with Kendall Gilding.
Welcome back. Our top stories this Friday. A humpback whale and her calf have been at the centre of a dramatic rescue operation on the Gold Coast. They were entangled in shark nets in choppy conditions until rescuers set them free. The Prime Minister has warned Australia is under attack from a sophisticated cyber force. Scott Morrison says all levels of government and some industries are being targeted. Experts suspect China could be the instigator. And Logan residents, fed up with criminals targeting their community, have taken the law into their own hands, armed with baseball bats. The vigilantes caught a trio of teens breaking into cars. The chair of Queensland's Crime and Corruption Commission says the public should not be concerned by a perceived increase in brazen bikie crimes. It follows an alleged ambush and shooting and a daylight attack at a Brisbane servo, both involving Bandidos club members. Tom Hartley has more.
Here in Archerfield, police are continuing to gather evidence at the car yard where a high-ranking bikie was allegedly ambushed yesterday. Senior Bandido Mario Vosmeyer was the alleged target. He's the former Brisbane president. His alleged attacker is suspected to be a long-time rival gang member from the Comancheros. The pair became involved in a scuffle in Vosmeyer's car yard, during which they fought over a semi-automatic gun. Vosmeyer was struck multiple times and several bullets were fired, hitting parked cars and buildings, but sparing bystanders and witnesses. This morning, police, from forensics officers to detectives, have returned to continue their investigation, but so far Vosmeyer is refusing to cooperate. The whereabouts and motive of his alleged attacker is unknown at this stage. This incident happened only hours after another bikie, Leonard David Tolai, allegedly smashed up a service station. He's been remanded in custody to face court on Monday. We asked the Deputy Premier his thoughts on these recent brazen incidents.
I'm concerned about crime and violence all of the time, and obviously these recent incidents are very concerning. I'm sure our police are working hard to get on top of them.
Not surprisingly, the bikies, as you call them, are always on our radar and always will be. And I'm not concerned about any perception, at least, of an increase in activity, because we are aware of it and on it, as it were.
All of the latest developments on these cases and more in the news at 6.
Millions of the country's lowest paid workers will receive a wage increase of $13 a week. But Australians in industries hardest hit by the pandemic will have to wait until next year. Laurel Irving has the details. Well, this was a scenario not faced before by Fair Work Australia, an economy battered on a scale that we haven't seen here for nearly a century. Employer groups say that businesses simply could not afford a wage rise. Well, Fair Work Australia has offered something of a compromise, ruling on a 1.75% increase. That's an extra $13 a week. The Commission, though, has said that the industry's hardest hit by the pandemic can have more time to pay. And so from July, healthcare, childcare workers will get their rise. In November, people in the manufacturing and construction sector. But in those industries hardest hit by the pandemic, retail, tourism, hospitality and aviation, they won't get their rise until February.
The outlook, including the nature and speed of the expected recovery, remains highly uncertain.
The Commission has said that a wage freeze would actually have sent more lower paid workers into poverty, but we've spoken to some people on the minimum wage today who say they are still distressed at the outcome.
Mortgage and bills, I don't know where to begin. I'm very, very disappointed.
And the ACTU says that a wage rise for our lowest paid workers will actually stimulate the economy because they're the workers most likely to spend their money on small business.
French President Emmanuel Macron has been royally welcomed to the UK, marking the 80th anniversary of a famous wartime speech. The overseas visit is Macron's first since his country went into coronavirus lockdown. Hugh Whitfeld reports.
This is one of the first visits by any major world leader anywhere because of the pandemic, and it seems world leaders are going to have to learn a new language of diplomacy. No more handshakes, no more backslapping. Instead, Emmanuel Macron used the Namaste greeting when arriving at Clarence House to meet Charles and Camilla. The Prince of Wales and the Duchess of Cornwall taking on more royal duties with the 94-year-old Queen remaining in lockdown at Windsor Castle. Emmanuel Macron also dropped by Downing Street for a socially distant chat with Boris Johnson, where they seemingly joked about the strange nature of international relations right now. This visit was all to mark and indeed celebrate the 80th anniversary of a historic radio broadcast by then French President Charles de Gaulle. He used the BBC to broadcast to his people across the channel in France, imploring them to resist the Nazi occupation at the time. De Gaulle was in exile here in London. At the moment, visitors to the UK do have to quarantine for 14 days. The French president, though, granted an exemption.
Police have dropped their charge against Greens councillor Jonathan Shree. He was arrested at a refugee protest on the weekend, accused of not following police direction.
Obviously, the police have realised their mistake and are now quietly dropping the charge to avoid embarrassment.
Councillor Shree wants an apology from police for arresting fellow protesters. A chilling interview has emerged of the African-American man who was shot dead by a police officer outside an Atlanta restaurant last week. Rayshard Brooks was speaking 4 months before he died about his struggles inside the justice system. Brooks called for people like himself to stop being treated like animals.
Well, I just feel like some of the system could, you know, look at us as individuals. We do have lives, you know, it's just a mistake we made.
The officer who shot Brooks has been charged with murder. Facebook has taken down campaign ads by US President Donald Trump that feature a symbol used in Nazi Germany for political prisoners. Team Trump claimed the inverted red triangle is widely used by left-wing activist group Antifa and hence was used in an ad against them. Trump blames the group for recent unrest. Until now, Facebook has been criticised over its hands-off approach to political speech. Let's check finance with Stephen Daglian at ComSec. Steve, how did the Australian market wrap up the week for investors?
Good afternoon, Kendall. It was a slightly disappointing end to what was actually a decent week for our market. So today the market up by just a tenth of a percent. We're up about 12 times as much a bit earlier in the day after a report showing that Australians have opened up their wallets again in the month of May. In fact, it was the biggest monthly percentage lift in spending across the country, and people started spending again on things like clothing, footwear and accessories as well. But over the week, shares still managed to lift by about 1.6%, so not too bad. We had the banks and miners was underperforming this afternoon, which weighed on the market. And some of the best were actually retail companies. The likes of bedding and homewares group Adairs, it was up about 10%. And also furniture group Nick Scali was up close to 20%. Both said that they've had very strong improvements in sales recently, despite COVID-19. The Aussie dollar finally a bit softer this week, sitting at about 68.5 US.
Always great to see you. Thanks so much, Stephen.
Thank you.
Here's a unique solution to working out safely during the coronavirus pandemic. The owner of this California gym has installed temporary workout pods made of pipes and shower curtains. The safety measure is luring back cautious gym junkies after a three-month closure. Drivers couldn't help but do a huge double take when they spotted this enormous pig on the trot in Adelaide. One of them quickly started filming the unexpected encounter in the city's north. Owners say the pig escaped from his pen to stretch his legs. He was quickly recaptured and returned to his backyard home. The day's sport is next with Pat Welsh, including the fallout for the Broncos after their fourth straight loss. Also, can a vitamin that we get from the sun help in the fight against allergies? And a surprise underwater encounter with a humpback whale.
Paid to drop your kids to school. The cashback for Queensland parents. Up to $100 a week.
A lot of parents don't know about it.
The school zones where you can claim.
It helps us heaps with the petrol.
How it's saving parents thousands across the year. Only on 7 News at 6 o'clock.
It's not Lady Gaga. She's only 10.
We're far from the shallow now.
Unbelievable.
Amazing is an understatement.
It didn't even seem humanly possible.
It was fantastic.
I want to see more.
So many awesome acts, we can't fit them all in. You can't miss new America's Got Talent. Wednesday, 7:30 on 7.
The MG Triple Value Sale is now on. Get triple value this month with $777 cash back across the range, an MG gift pack and MG 7-year unlimited kilometre warranty. Hurry, offer ends soon.
Hi, Chris. As one of our Care Super members, let's go see your super at work.
Hold on.
I'll show you some of the opportunities and possibilities that are being explored for you. Your super should work as hard as you do, so we're making sure it does.
If you're road tripping, RACQ has you covered. More Queenslanders trust us to insure their cars and come to their rescue with 5 levels of roadside assistance. Plus, members save on fuel and more. Get yourself road trip ready with RACQ.
Most Australians are using their home internet very differently nowadays, with video conferencing, online study and streaming often going on at the same time. Many of these require high upload and download speeds, so it might be worth checking whether the speed plan you chose when you first switched to the NBN network is still the best one for you. For more home internet help, visit nbn.com.au/optimise.
Anaconda's super stock take sale is on now with Cape Thermals just $10 and save $130 on Keensteen's adult waterproof hikers, now only $119. Head in store or shop online at anacondastores.com.
Anaconda!
At the heart of RACQ is Queenslanders helping Queenslanders. With the support of our members, together we are making a difference. We've raised vital funds for UQ's COVID-19 research. The RACQ helicopter and jet rescue network is assisting with patient transfers. And now RACQ Foundation is extending funding to community groups impacted by COVID-19. Together, we're helping Queensland's recovery. That's what it means to be a member of RACQ.
Metropolitan for plumbing. Metropolitan for electrical. Metropolitan for air conditioning. Plumbing, electrical, air conditioning. Same prices for after hours. Metropolitan plumbing, electrical and air conditioning.
You've never seen a kitchen appliance store like Brisbane Appliance Sales. Customer experience is our priority with over 80 years combined industry knowledge. Brisbane Appliance Sales are a true family business. Come and meet the team. Inaugural Road, Newmarket.
Jack Nicholson is the ultimate bachelor searching for love.
Don't you like girls your own age?
The all-star cast in Something's Gotta Give, tonight on 7.
Researchers are examining whether vitamin D supplements can stop children developing food allergies. As Georgia Commensoli explains, it's thought a deficiency impacts toddlers' immune systems.
Good afternoon. 1 in 10 Australian children right now are living with food allergies, the highest rate in the world. But what if the answer to reducing those figures was a bit of vitamin D?
What we're looking to do is prevent food allergy in the first place and eradicate food allergy from being a problem. And our particular aim at the Murdoch here is to prevent children needing to go to school with an EpiPen.
The Vitality trial run by the Murdoch Children's Research Institute in Melbourne is halfway through.
The modern lifestyle and environmental factors seem to be key to why food allergy is on the rise. And part of that is an overly hygienic lifestyle of the Australians, but also living far away from the equator.
Keandra and her son Toby have been in the trial for the last year.
The more we know, the easier it is, and often, you know, it'd be something that I'm eating and I want to give him a taste and I'd think, oh, actually no, I think it's got peanuts in it, and what if he has reactions?
The trial also gave them a free allergy panel, and 17-month-old Toby has no allergies. The trial needs another 1,700 babies before it's completed, and if it works, it could be available for household use in 3 years' time.
Well, Pat joins me now for a quick look at Friday sport.
Kendall, thank you. Hello, everyone. Suspensions and team changes loom after another horror outing for the Broncos. They remain winless since the NRL resumed and have been discarded by his premiership threats by bookmakers. They gave out 4 tries to Newcastle last night and for the 4th straight week failed to score a point in the second half.
We've killed ourselves, we honestly have. We need to be smarter how we play our footy. You know, we've got some talented guys there, but just we're not giving ourselves a chance.
The pressure piling up on coach and players, exacerbated by looming one-match bans for Pat Carrigan and Tom Flegler after a late tackle and a crusher. Lions coach Chris Fagan's unfazed by the prospect of being without his skipper tomorrow night against West Coast at the Gabba. Already missing Man Mountain Steph Martin with injury, Dane Zorko's nursing an Achilles strain. While the captain insists he'll be right, the coach won't take any risks just 3 rounds in.
Oh, man.
Squads win premierships. Teams win matches. So not sure which way to go, but at this stage he's named in the team and no doubt he'll give it his best shot.
The blockbuster tomorrow night live and free on the screens of 7. For the first time in 68 years, the Queen wasn't in attendance at Royal Ascot's famous Gold Cup, but history was still made with favourite Stradivarius winning his 3rd straight trophy.
He's going to absolutely street them, the best player in the world, Stradivarius, 3 Gold Cups clear of DF Road.
The meet was held without crowds due to the coronavirus pandemic. That is one hell of a racehorse.
Sure is. Thanks, Pat. We'll see you at 6.
Mm-hmm.
A professional Airlie Beach camera operator has had a memorable encounter with a giant of the deep. A humpback whale swam up close to him off the coast of Hayman Island. Ben Crisp was snorkeling and filming when he captured the underwater moment. Ben says he's been waiting and hoping to get that close to a whale. Well, are you planning a day trip this weekend? Paul Burt has the all-important weather forecast next. Also, a special phone call from Hollywood to cheer up kids in hospital. And she's back, your first look at Gold Coast singer Amy Shark's new single. On 7 News, Australia's massive cyber attack, what you must do. The race to save humpbacks off Main Beach. Logan vigilantes take on serial thieves. COVID-19 bargains, ultra-cheap airfares.
As low as $19.
Fees slashed on uni degrees and the caterer selling $2 meals. 7 News at 6.
Well, good afternoon. It's Ben in the Victoria's basement traffic chopper. This is the current snapshot around the north side this afternoon. Look at this, it's absolutely crawling through Deegan all the way through to Bald Hills onto the Bruce Highway. And there's a little bit of traffic building up through Brighton into Clontarf for the Houghton Highway Bridge. Cook up, bake up. Famous Victoria's Basement is open online with up to 85% off cookware and kitchenware essentials. Shop online at victoriasbasement.com.au. Stay safe on the roads and have a great weekend.
Captain Strand, we want you to come down to Texas to build an entire station from scratch.
Okay, but I choose the firefighters.
This crew can't just be good. Have you got what it takes? They gotta be the best.
Nassim is medical, so I run the call. So you do what I say, Captain.
Have you got what it takes to fight, to rule?
Rob Lowe.
Let's show them all we got.
And Liv Tyler.
I think a man should have to earn his cowboy boots.
Get ready for the new action thrill ride. New 911 Lone Star on 7.
Thanks for calling ING. This is Adam speaking. How can I help you? No, I'm currently working from home.
Oh, you can call anytime, so...
Sorry. And she's currently nibbling at my toe right now.
Yeah, working from home was a bit tricky at first, but...
There's definitely been some stray farts, hasn't there, mate?
And now your loan's on a fixed rate. Can I help you with anything else?
Nah, you made my day.
Well, whatever 2020 throws at you, we're here for a chat anytime.
Too easy.
We've all been very caught up in what's happening.
It's actually a lot more positive than I expected.
They're supporting one another more.
When they smile and they say thank you, that makes my day worthwhile.
Keeping the energy up, keeping the vibes up, that's what I'm trying to do.
People aren't giving the elderly enough credit. They are resilient and they're encouraging us.
Bringing joy and love through the simplest little things.
Our Care, five-star aged care.
What are you looking at, hon?
Oh, just a little bit of T&W.
Huh? Hey, I've got a package for Anna.
Wow, you're here already?
Temple & Webster. Save today on our massive end of financial year sale.
Are you ready to get back to life as you love it? Get full digital news access plus weekend home paper delivery for just $5 a month for the first 3 months. Call 1-800-323-111 today.
With Belong, you get 10 gigs of mobile data for $25 a month. That's 10 gigs of family time, plus unlimited international calls and texts to selected countries for $5 extra. Together, we're different. Belong.
At Terry White Chemmart, we're here to help this winter. That's why pharmacists like Bridget are trained to administer flu vaccinations right here in store. Book now. Walk-ins also available. Terry White Chemmart. Now that's real chemistry.
Look forward to the weekend, because tomorrow is Super Weekend at Myer. Make the most of great offers online right now or in-store tomorrow. Don't miss out on Super Weekend.
Myer, my store.
The Super Nerd.
Time for laughing is over.
The Super Team.
My worst nightmare.
Get ready for Australia's 5 o'clock obsession to go supercharged.
Indian friend league.
Dolphins team.
Gone.
New The Chase, weekdays on 7.
This weather report brought to you by Bridgestone Select for tyres and car servicing.
Good afternoon, Queensland. You are watching 7 News as we come to you live from the beautiful Narang River on the Gold Coast. It certainly has been a bit of a sort of like a windy, showery, sunny day today. Some fantastic rainbows being seen around the southeast as well. And obviously those stiff southeasterly trades continuing to blow up the coast. Let's take a look at the charts now and see exactly what's happening over the next 24 to 36 hours. Well, today we can see that large high moving off the southern Victorian coast into the southern Tasman. That's directing that southeast trade directly up the east coast. We're seeing some swell from a low that was previously in the eastern side of the Tasman. That's still pushing in an easterly swell at this stage. It'll stay with us for the weekend, so good news there for the surfers. Winds will drop off a little bit tomorrow too, so fantastic news, but still blowing some moisture onto the coast, so I expect a little bit of shower activity for the next, I'd say till probably early Sunday morning, and then clearing up by the afternoon as westerlies start to move through. But for those in the far south, blizzard type conditions for the southern majors. Have a look at that deep low in the southern bight, and that's going to intensify tomorrow, so some cold weather set for Victoria and Tasmania. In fact, temperatures are getting up to highs of only around 15 degrees for Hobart, 16 in Melbourne, 14 for Adelaide, 13 Canberra. The place to be, if you're allowed to go over the borders, 10 to 20 for Sydney. To the tropics now, a couple of showers for Cairns down towards Mackay. Partly cloudy, mostly sunny around Townsville, tops of 27 degrees. Similar around the Wide Bay Burnett regions and also Capricornia coasts. 25 to 23 degrees, looking good out there. 9 to 17 and partly cloudy for Toowoomba. Back home, a couple of coastal showers moving through. Top temperatures of around 21 degrees across most of the southeast, down to about 9 degrees for Ipswich tonight, 14 on the coast. Kendall, I'll see you at 6 with your full weekend weather wrap.
Looking forward to it. Thanks, Birdie. Well, Sharon's here for a look at tonight's news and an amazing rescue off the Gold Coast today. Yes, Kendall, as you've seen earlier, a humpback whale and her baby were caught in shark nets off Main Beach. Despite rough conditions and driving rain, a team from SeaWorld was able to set them free, and we'll speak with the rescuers at 6.
Also, who would have thought being a kid's taxi driver might bring a reward?
Yeah, I'm not sure about that one, Kendall, but if you do drive your children to school every day, there is a little known claim you can make. There are a couple of catches, but you never know, you may be eligible.
Plus some big COVID savings, including cheap meals.
Yeah, because of the travel downturn, a caterer for a major airline is overstocked and needs to offload food fast. That means you can pick up meals for as little as $2, and tonight we'll tell you how. Those stories and plenty more coming up in the news at 6. We'll see you then.
Thanks, Sharon. Well, imagine interviewing your favourite celebrity. That's a dream that became reality for some kids at Queensland Children's Hospital today when they received a video call from Captain Jack Sparrow. The star of the Pirates of the Caribbean franchise, Johnny Depp, visited the hospital while filming on the Gold Coast in 2015. And today he dialed in to Juice TV to answer some questions but ended up asking his own.
How old are you, Gabby?
I'm 17.
So am I.
Oh, really?
And a half.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, who's counting, really?
During the more than hour-long call, Captain Sparrow danced, told stories, and revealed he can't wait to come back to Australia. Let's check social media now. Gold Coast singer Amy Shark dropped her new single at midnight, and the video clip has been clocking up views since then. The song is called Everybody Rise. Have mercy on me. Everybody rise for you. Everybody cries like I do. It's the first new music from the singer in 2 years. The song was scheduled to be released in April, but was delayed due to the pandemic. And HBO Max has released a 30-second teaser trailer for the latest Justice League installment. It's a rework of the 2017 movie with the original director back at the helm. We will be waiting a while to see it, though. It's not set to be released until 2021. And make sure you stay connected over the weekend. You can like our pages on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. That's our 4pm news for another week. Thanks for joining us. The Chase is coming up next, then 7 News at 6 with Max and Sharon. I'm Kendall Gilding. Have a great weekend.
Twist.